Mercury, they were actually working together, of course, in this episode, but it got a little weird. There was an argument in the middle of your turn.
Oh, yes.
Take a look at this.
All right, so,
Mer, you've been probed and abducted already, right? Q, you're praying it happens to you, but the odds are slim.
You know how, like, you were lucky, you got abducted, and they probed you and everything like that?
It wasn't luck, bud. It wasn't enjoyable. It was traumatic and horrifying.
Anyway,
what I'm saying is, you remember that time that you got abducted and I didn't?
Yes.
Well, I was thinking, if the aliens won't come to me and probe me, I'll go to them and let them probe me.
In my experience getting probed, it has been not my choice. I don't think you can choose to get probed by aliens.
Yeah, but it's easy for you to talk about getting probed like it's no big thing when you get probed all the time. I want to get probed.
Well, this you're understanding. This is not a good thing. It was not enjoyable getting probed.
You're probe dusting the whole place.
Do you know the pain I felt after getting probed in the from aliens? It was not enjoyable. My still hurts.
You cannot say probe and enough.
You know what it's like to have an unprobed
I wish I could remember. I've been probed in the so many times. Let's say you spend a year of your life building a ship to go up to space, yeah. Right? And you get up there, and they don't want to probe your a**. You've wasted a year of your life.
Do you guys believe in aliens, though?
Is that yeah. Well, yeah.
I do.
Statistically, one out of four of every group of friends is an alien.
Oh, they're going to say an asshole.
Both.
Today we're going head-to-head tournament style, clipping balloons onto unsuspecting shoppers.
We'll be taking turns attaching balloons and trying not to get caught.
Let's do this.
Let's do it.
Ready to do it?
All right, let's go.
Giddy up, little doggy.
And action.
Copy that.
Let's do it.
Let's do this.
All right, guys, let's do it.
Let's do this.
When are we doing this?
Now! Commence!
Hop to it, fellas.
Don't get cocky. Don't get cocky.
Yeah!
This is going to be ugly.
You're going to be ugly.
Go give him hell, bud.
Good luck. God bless America.
Me, huma cow cow, I come mocking.
What does that mean?
Best of luck.
It's hammocka time.
Oh.
You need to work it, girl. I'm gonna throw pastrami all up in this mother.
Let's just get this started.
Let's just get
let's
to
just,
it.
You want it? Let's just start it.
This is the part where we say something funny and cut out.
I don't know if this is a good idea.
You guys ready?
Let's do it.
Let's go.
Here we go.
It's a good commute.
It certainly looks more magical when you don't show it.
Yeah.
You know, if you refuse, you lose. Come on, sevens. Are we ready to go?
Ready? Somebody clap. I'm sorry.
You need one clap.
That's a double clap in case I missed the first one.
Does that throw them off?
No, this is all perfect. We're ready to go. Hey, guys. Thanks so much for joining us for a hashtag Ask a Joker. We've done it. Season 7. Thank you so much. We love you guys.
Another one done.
We'll be back for season 8 early next year. But now let's get to the questions. You went online and asked hashtag Ask a Joker. You got us all here. It's a party.
This is Impractical Joker's Staten Island Holiday Spectacular.
Peggy asks, Mer, what was your favorite moment from this season?
Mine?
When did you laugh the hardest?
The hide-and-seek challenge.
Yes.
Where only Joe and I knew it, and we had to film ourselves on our cell phones and hide from the person cleaning the warehouse.
This might have been a bad idea. We were four grown men playing hide-and-go-seek.
Still fun.
It's still fun.
She didn't know she was seeking Gus.
Hi.
Yeah! Murray lost!
Luna asks, Sal, have you ever forgiven the other guys? You say you never would.
Oh, when I scream, I'll never forgive you in the credits?
Yes.
Yeah. I will never forgive you!
Yeah, I haven't forgiven them. man of my word. Yeah,
we're hoping next season that we're able to pull
this
off.
This is the most I've really spoken to them off camera.
I gotta be honest, I'm not that concerned about it.
Sal, we're not off camera.
Off the TV show camera, and now you just dug yourself a bigger hole.
Yeah, this is the only way we can talk to you. We have to record all conversations with them.
I hate certain people.
Oh my God.
Can't stand them.
Yeah. Oh my God. I will never forgive you.
Rachel asks, Q, what celebrity have you been most tongue-tied around? Whoa. Let's take it easy. Get a little personal.
I have this. I met Bill Murray, and that was huge.
Yes, that's right.
I was very tongue-tied around Bill Murray.
You were also drinking?
Yeah, but that's kind of that usually loosens the old tongue up. A little too much sometimes.
Too much.
Tones writes, when you watch episodes from season one, what do you notice the most?
How a big fat we were. And that's it. You know, that was before high definition, which I was very happy about. I look much better pixelated.
And what do you mean we were?
We got to fill our bellies with some traditional holiday dishes, you know? We don't like to do anything without loading up.
You're right. Yeah, you're very much right. You're very much right. We still are. But hey, at least we're consistent.
Mm-hmm.
Take that, Tones. I don't like your tones, and I'm just going to say it.
Guys,
we gotta wrap this up soon. Mara's got to get back on the shelf. Thanks so much, guys, for joining us in this season. We love you. Here's a round of applause for you guys.
Go see us on tour. The Cranjers and Basketball World Comedy Tour. Go to thetenderloins.com for tickets or impracticaljokers.com. If you don't see your city, check again, because we'll be touring this thing for years and years and years, and we're definitely coming
to find you.
And the Joker's movie comes out 2019.
Hopefully.
One time I saved a woman.
One time I actually saved a woman with my sword. I ran out with my sword, I scanned him away, I gave him a whap on the bottom.
Then I got laid.
Then I got laid.
Keep telling the story, but keep talking about how you got laid.
Yeah, she was super grateful because, like, she had her kids in the car, and when you have your kids in the car, you're not thinking you're gonna get laid. You know, there she was getting harassed by these street tough, and out came this handsome baked potato. And then he comes out, and I parried away. Next thing you know, we're getting laid, both of us, me and her. She dropped off the kids at home to get laid, and then we just laid.
We just laid.
You know, and it was great. I didn't even have to take her to a movie or anything before I laid her because I already saved a life. So if someone saves your life, you kind of got laid them. You know what I mean? All right, laid. Let me see you two.
Yeah.
Congratulations on dressing appropriately for a cleaning job, boys. He's got a cardigan. You got a friggin' $300 sweater on.
Look how Murray dressed down. He threw a rag on his belt.
Real in-touch working men over here today.
There you go, Sal. Really selling it.
There we go.
Sal, say to Murray, just to wrap up the conversation we were having.
Just to wrap up the conversation we were having earlier.
After seven long, difficult years, we finally found my mother's body under the house.
Yeah. So after seven long, difficult years, we finally found my mother's body under the house.
That's where it was? That's where it was.
I'm gonna start dusting this.
All right, I'm over here.
Guys, this girl's a rookie. Just keep telling rookie mistake.
It's a rookie mistake there.
Oh, yeah, the way
it's probably a rookie mistake. It's all right, rookie, don't worry about it.
You know what it is? It's the tighter the inside of it is, the smaller the rug I should be. But yeah, you just roll it really tight. It's a rookie mistake. It happens. There you go. Perfect. Perfect. Yeah.
It's all right, rookie.
You know what the truth is? You guys should show that. We don't throw right now. That's editing magic. What I do is I say, we'll show you the clip, and I pause, and then they cut it, and then they put the thing in. It's not real time. They're trying to get one over on you. We've already wasted enough of your time with the ads up top and all that thing. We tried to get right into it, and now I have to over-explain this because your time is precious.
Okay, you gotta give him direction because he's gonna talk all the time.
Yeah.
As if there's not two people holding on camera, and I'm like, he's a jerk.
Who's that?
Sal. Baby. Sal,
okay. Looks like a tangerine. This will only take about 5 minutes or so, 10 minutes. So if
you want to shut the
Yeah, thank you.
Smoke and mirrors.
Do me a favor. Can you just beep the f*** you and leave it in? That was very funny. I'm gonna cut to the next thing. You can leave all that in too. But F you, they know the show. This is really, that's gold. Really, it's gold. All right. In case they beeped it out, I just told Morgan to f*** you. In case they beeped it out, I just reminded you that I told Morgan to f*** you 2 minutes ago. Remember when I said f*** you, Morgan?
Bump, 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 bump. Let me take a sip of my drink that's not cleared first.
You want to see me slap your uncle?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Watch your back, literally. Watch your backside.
Khalib says, what was your childhood like? Not the whole thing, but the highlights. That's pretty deep. My childhood was awesome, in a word. I was geeky growing up, but a lot of fun.
I think that maybe Q maybe gets recognized the most, because Q kind of has like a uniform. All right, we're going to stay on me, right? This way we don't get interrupted by him the whole time. All right.
And here you see James there. And so anyway.
Yeah, I don't know what was going to happen.
More work coming and the show is still on. So for those we do, but like for the other 100 episodes, I usually just watch Cowering Under the Covers by myself.
Hi.
Hi.
There's a person taking a photo of me right now. Hi, thank you. I'm recording as we speak. Now you're on the show too. So there you go. Come sit next to me. Come sit next to me. You gotta, the tour.
As I'm doing this chat, my mom called. Hello? She has no idea. She has no idea I'm doing this. Let's see. Hey, Ma.
Hi, you calling me?
Didn't call you.
Oh, yes, you did.
Let me check. Hold on. Let me check my log calls. Hold on. What are all the guys' middle names? Also, if you could change your middle name to something else, what would it be?
Good question.
I'll take it when I want it.
Oh, here comes Al. All right. Say hi, Al. All right, Al is one of the cameramen on our show. He's been with us for a long, long time.
First season.
One of my favorite crew members, without a doubt. I'm not just saying that because you're here. Aw. In just a few moments after I finish answering this, I'm going to open this elevator. I'm going to go in there, and I am going to, what's that? No? All right. I'm not gonna go in there. That's a joke.
I'm passing them out, bro. While you were in here doing this, we're partying.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
And you need in a year. No, we're shooting right now. We're shooting! Oh my God, what are you doing? It's chaos!
Oh my God.
Here's your gum. Oh my God, what have you ruined everything?
A seafoam and a light green. People are getting yelled at lunch. That's what's happening here. You want to see who yelled at? Come here. Shay, come here a sec. This little body that has that big voice. This is one of our ADs. This is Shay, and she's amazing. And she yells that she wants you to know there's no second plates. Okay, thank you, Shay. There's no second plates. Shay will break your neck if you go get a second plate.
Come on, sound guy. Hey, everybody.
You guys, of course, had to pitch products, right? And it was to these focus groups. But however, tonight, it was the first time that you specifically made children's toys. Well, we didn't see all the toys that you guys had to try and sell.
Yeah.
So, of course, he had an unusual one in this bonus clip. So, take a look from tonight's episode.
So, this is the impossible puzzle. It contains approximately 10,000 non-matching, non-interlocking puzzle pieces.
Wait, none of the pieces match?
None. The best part is if you lose a piece, it doesn't matter. Like, literally, your children will be frustrated and occupied for hours and hours.
That could be a funny gag gift.
No, it's to keep kids occupied.
You know what it is? They don't have the brain capacity to realize that it's a complete scam.
They don't have the brain capacity yet to figure out that the
kids
puzzle doesn't make sense. In my experience, they're not.
There's a commercial.
Impossible. 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 Impossible.
It's impossible.
Yes, definitely impossible.
Same when she did Central Park.
That had to be millions of people, a million people.
Oh, there have always been millions of people there. I mean, I just... open...
farting bubbles!
My last concert in Central Park was Sting.
Yeah, who's Sting? Wow, Murray held strong.
Yeah.
Look at Joe's face. So contemplative.
In Central Park.
Yeah, would you say that the Upper East Side has a neighborhood feel?
Yeah, it seems just a little out of the way to me.
Right.
Yeah, I don't know.
Right.
I guess the...
Cannoli. It's a giant cannoli. What are the subway lines you take the most?
Mostly I go between Queens and Manhattan.
You with skeleton inside you?
No, I'm two kids standing on top of each other.
You get a lot that there's a neighborhood feel.
Here we go. Here we go.
Astoria?
Hey, Sal, this is what the kids call a walk in the park. We have to get you to laugh.
You guys all talk a good game. You all keep talking this good game.
All right.
You watch. Look at me, ready?
Yeah.
Watch this.
Oh. Fart noise. You didn't even make the fart noise. I said the worst fart noise.
That's what was funny about it. Hey, how are you, bud? What's going on? My name is Sal.
I'm Zachary.
Zachary, pleasure to meet you.
Let me go help this guy.
Yeah, go get him, Tiger.
How often do you feel the need to update software, things like that kind of stuff?
I mean, I have a laptop, but I really don't use it anymore because of the new technology, like right. The smartphones and things like that. It's just...
As far as, sorry, I'm trying to think as we go through all the things you've got.
Oh, it's not over yet, buddy. This is gonna haunt your dreams, my friend.
Talk to me about your opinions on the subway system.
Depending on the public transportation, as far as it's a lot of idiotic people that's on the train that does stupid things.
Oh, just it's
the
meeting whole time.
Train for no reason. They have nothing better to do or anywhere but oh wants to go.
God.
I know.
They do have a good public transportation.
Subway system sucks.
Yeah, the train is horrible.
Train is horrible.
Yeah, as far as like getting around to the like different boroughs.
I'm next. Let's see what I got up my sleeve.
Just please elaborate on basketball.
Q has guaranteed us that he's got this. I trust him.
He's got it.
He's got it.
Do you online bank?
Yes, I do.
Okay.
It's your father marrying you. He's not giving him away. We now kiss the bride.
The eyes, like the voice, but now it's the contestants that can't see. Singers are blindfolded and must find the stage through a maze filled with booby traps. Oh, look out for that sand pit, Patricia. If they find the mic, they can sing, but it's not mandatory. So imagine you've got the best singing competition in the world, but they have to physically be able to get there.
Well, that's not what it's written, because they don't have to sing if they don't want
they don't to. Have to sing.
And it's not a singing. They're basically just trying to find a microphone while wearing a blindfold. Yeah.
I like it.
Okay, when duty calls, when on vacation, retired detective Duke Sweats receives an urgent call while in the middle of dropping kids off at the pool. It appears his ex-wife has gone missing. What choice does a man have when duty calls?
Duty calls, he's dropping his kids off at the pool.
Thinking like almost like a Netflix, like we just drop the whole season in one day. We just, Mondo Duke season, we just drop all in one day.
You could film it like in Miami.
Yeah, now you call it. Right, so it's like steaming. It's like hot, it's steamy. Yeah.
You guys think that was good?
Yeah.
What's going to find out about business card?
Remind him that you have the right to review service.
We're gonna get you a couple of specs for that. You can do different finishes and stuff like that. I will remind you though, at any time we do have the right to refuse service.
Yeah, at any time.
Why would you do that? It's just a policy that we have in case things start going in a way that we don't appreciate. Oh, sure.
Explain to them the longest promotional deal in the world and do it at the same time.
It's basically a fall special.
Yeah. So if you want to pick up, if you want to deliver them online,
special, as long as it's done by
here,
October 31st,
and you can get them to come
month,
through, we deliver them down the street,
an order of 500 or 30% off, an order of 1,000%
off.
He is thoroughly confused.
Tell them about the rebate.
There is a rebate.
So you can mail in rebate.
In store. And mail in. You could
then
choose which one that
then
you like.
Both a mail in and in store rebate right now.
Okay. keep going.
You can put them like with
different fonts and
musicians that
well.
Put them on guitar picks.
Thing,
or
right,
so we just need to make their business look like a different thing and stand out. Well, some of the business cards pop out. The entire catalog's on there.
And that's 10 to 15% off for an order of 500
if you ever want.
And you want to buy October 31st. That's really the point.
Well, I'll take a look at this and come back.
Yeah, just as a reminder, we have the right to refuse service.
I will check that out.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you.
Is this yours?
Yeah.
You don't give popcorn to somebody on camera, man. It just gets caught in your throat.
You look like you're pregnant with an adult.
I love Joe. But the man is not physically fit.
I'll dry up in this thing. I'll dry up my way to a donut.
So it's a natural fit to make him do gymnastics.
Look at him.
It looks like you have a medicine ball in your shirt.
I can't do anything gymnastic-like. I have problems rolling out of bed in the morning.
I've never met anybody that is in such bad shape but is so proud of it.
The boys like to use my body against me, but I own this thing.
Let it go.
Hashtag sexy.
There's only been a few times that I've crumbled on the show. Joe in the gymnastics punishment was one of those times. When he ran at the vault and his body did not gain any vertical height, it flew completely parallel to the earth.
Just falls into the abyss. In the most ungraceful way, you could fall into a batch of foam and disappear to the bottom.
I felt like I fell into a bottomless hole. I felt like space. If I was stuck in space, that's what it was. I couldn't get out, and all I could hear in my ear was them dying laughing.
Murray and I lost it.
I was crying for 5 minutes. I missed him trying to crawl out of the ball pit. I missed the girl pulling him up.
Put your back into it.
I did not see any of that until it was on TV.
Would you two idiots get up? I'm just standing there, one man standing, carrying the whole show. Probably got better ratings because of it, actually.